Welcome to episode 5 of Abzu. I'm your host, Lostwolfe, and before we go into the door, I just want to point out very quickly, I'm above the door, because this is where the game puts you once you come out of that. That's a giant squid, and of course giant squid are the people who are responsible for making the game. So we have their actual representation here. So in we go. More like over we go. Hey, Mr. Camera, you can behave. Come on, guy. It's not that hard. Right. That's better. Ooh. So in keeping with the idea of night as a metaphor, we're diving deeper down. We're going deeper into the night. As we go into the night, we encounter more and more frightening things, of course. Now, we've encountered these permas before, and of course, they weren't great for our longevity or anything. And we're noticing that some kind of fish is trying to go in there. And we've got to make it in there too. Because something has already gone in, we don't have to open the door here. Of course, now that we're here, we're seeing sort of the big scale of our creators' makings. And unfortunately, they've left things behind that are not altogether savory, like those bombs that we've encountered before. Let's see, where do we want to go? We want to go down. Manufacturing plant of some sort. As we can see here, it is manufacturing our little robot friends that we've seen before stuck in the water. So those aren't entirely unique. This is one of the very few cases where I'm not altogether crazy about the camera. Because the camera's a little too close to you, yeah. I'm gonna wait. I think I can get by. Yes. And the other thing that we're seeing here is we're seeing a couple of those permits too. And notice also another thing is that this is all underwater at present. So their manufacturing happens in the water. So, we have a little story here. I'll run by it again just so that we can see it and so you can understand. But we have our little buddies, and our little buddies sometimes store energy. We take the energy, or the energy gets pulled in through the doors. But lots more energy here. And of course we have us. And we store energy too. We can sort of tell that that is us by the shape of the head. So we are essentially a receptacle for this civilization's energy, which we've seen before because we've unleashed the energy. As if though that wasn't sort of confirmation enough, we have these little electronic devices here. These all little manufactured guys. I'm probably not going the right way. I think they want me to go this way. Yes, indeed. We're all going to swim together as a kind of school. You can tell that this is the handiwork of the abzu folks because they have the sort of same stylistic imprint. There's lots of triangles and that sort of thing. Went in a massive circle. Of course I did. Aha! How do I know? Because this is the same story. There we go. Just went in a giant circle. I'm not good with games that don't give you a map. Unfortunately, that's one of those places where I fall down a lot. Is this not where we want to go? Yes, I think it is. Yeah, the camera here isn't the best. And this is my least favorite bit of abzu. So here we have a giant minefield. And the idea behind the giant minefield is we need to cross the giant minefield to get to the door on the other side. But this is sort of the worst thing that can happen because these things will go off en masse and they will shock you and they'll keep you from moving forward. This is my least favorite bit of abzu. The last time I played this, I didn't make it through in one piece the first time. I kept on getting stuck, like I'm about to do now, and you'll see what happens is you get trapped in a bad loop. And yeah, this is not the best place to suddenly start with game mechanics. We have somehow survived what happened to us. As you can see, it didn't really do us any good, or it wasn't a good thing for us, because we got kind of fried. And as you can see, our circuitry was exposed there. And here we have the actual kind of... We've been looking at the suit that we've been dressed in. But here we have the actual inner sort of look of who we are. So we know now that we are a mechanized being. But the problem here is what actually happened in our little cutscene there. The shark, the great white, did us a service and did us a kindness. It's been leading us along all this way. And in a sense, it's been trying to warn us about the danger of the civilization that we were attached to. And the shark knew that if we tried to trigger the device, it may not have worked out quite as well for us, because we are a mechanized being. So we might have gotten trapped there forever. And the shark didn't want that. This is maybe the saddest part of Abzu. It's both beautiful and sad. The shark did us a great kindness by giving his life so that we might be able to carry on and go forward. Because Abzu means, or one of its meanings anyway, is the Sea of Wisdom. And the shark wanted us to accumulate and have this wisdom so that when we encountered our own kind again, we might not necessarily do this again. But to do that, it had to give its own life. Oh, I'm being terrible. Come on. Call. There we go. This is the only time in Abzu that we will ever be on land. This is the sort of algae farm and the kind of thing that must have been very common for the civilization of Abzu, or the Abzu people. And these great big, and we've seen them before, these great big temples. And at one point, this must have been the kind of thing that was dotting this area from end to end. So in this temple, the Abzu people did probably their worship. They probably did their harvesting. And they did the great cycle of harmony that we've seen before. At some point, in the distant past, of course, this must have been exactly what the Abzu people would have been seeing. We have birds. It's very beautiful and peaceful. And we had the buildings that the Abzu people created. one of the most beautiful dives in the game. Just diving right into the water. Again, I believe these are people I've freed before in my previous game. So we don't have to free them again. Which is a pity, because this is the sort of thing I wanted to show you when I thought of playing this game. There are some stairs here, so let's follow the stairs upward. Once again, we have great machinery at work. Open doors open. We need to find the other door. Now, one interesting thing to notice about this particular temple is that some of it is submerged. So, if we look over here, it'll take us there. You can see that this door is very big. It is ostensibly the biggest door that we've encountered so far. Well, let's see if we can follow this particular thread to its beginning. I see it. Following the chain. There we go. I believe if we go around this corner here, I probably missed it on the way in. But there is, I think, a section. Over there. We need to get there. Let's have a look around and see what we can see. Oh, goodness. Guy. You're supposed to pick up on the ledge and grab, friend. Yeah. Are you going to help out? Yes. There we go. I love the color scheme here. It's so beautiful. We are giving of our energy, the energy that we possess inside of us, to open up these doors. Because all of the abzu machinery runs on the energy of the sea. Down we go. Much less spectacular jump. But here we are. So since this particular temple is as big as it is, we have now seen that the doors have opened at the top and the bottom. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to leave it here, and when we come back tomorrow, we will go through the door, and we'll see what there is to see. Thank you so much for watching. I've been your host, Lost Wolf. This has been Abzu, episode 5, and I hope that you're enjoying this as much as I'm enjoying playing it for you. Have a great evening, folks, and good night for now.